In today's quick tip, let me show you how I transform a simple cartoon lips into more realistic ones. I have a palette of colors on one layer. The central lip line is on another. The lip itself, that I call lip's base color, is located above the background. The first step is to duplicate the lip's base color layer. I always turn off my layer and lock it. This ensures that my attention and edits are only directed to the duplicated layer. Click on the duplicated layer to activate it. Create a new layer on the top. Holding the Shift key, select both layers. Hit Ctrl plus G to create a group. Click on the new layer and activate the Alpha Inheritance button. From now on, each time you create new layers within this group, don't forget to activate the Alpha Inheritance button. These layers will become your clipping masks. Using any basic digital brush, pick the darkest color on the palette. As a quick reminder to pick a color, hit the Ctrl key on your keyboard. Activate the horizontal mirror tool. Resize your brush and trace a thick line underneath the central lip line. Then, using the eraser mode of a brush, refine your line. Time to blend colors. In your brush preset, find this brush, Blender Blur. This blending brush is a default brush. It is found in the KRITA 3 default resources bundle. Decrease the opacity and the flow of a brush and blend lightly the colors. Back to your digital brush. Create a new layer and activate the Alpha Inheritance. Pick the next color. The color must be lighter than the previous one, but still darker than the base color. Create a thick area that will cover some part of the upper lip and some part of the lower lip. Just watch me. As always, use the eraser mode of a brush to refine your work. Move the layer underneath. Back to the blender brush, modify the parameters of the brush as needed and blend this area nicely. Finally, and this is optional, you can rename your layers. Create a new layer above the lips base color layer and rename it light area. Pick a light color. This time use the brush called AIRBRUSH Soft and start painting light areas on both upper and lower lips. Now don't forget to use the eraser mode of the brush to refine your work and then, as earlier, blend the colors. Back to the layer we named Dark Area. Pick the dark color again. Using the brush AIRBRUSH Soft, add more shadows to the lips. You will need to test different brush parameters to get the best effects. Just take your time. We are almost done. Create a new layer. Pick the lightest color of the color palette. We are still using the brush AIRBRUSH Soft. Modify the brush parameters again and start painting highlights. Oh, I almost forgot. You will need to deactivate the horizontal mirror before starting to paint. Playing with a different flow and opacity, create white dots of different sizes and transparency. And you are done. You can keep working and tweak the colors of your lips if you want. I hope this quick tip was helpful. I will see you next time. Until then, happy creating!